come to the award ceremony, and the first category that we have is for Best Rated 4 Hyperscale Data Center Provider. And the winner of this category is... Yes, that's right. The winner of the first category award is CtrlS. Can we please give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the media wall for the Quantic Business Media at the BFSI Excellence Awards 2021. With me is a very exciting guest, Mr. Paresh Shetty, the President Sales from Cloud4C Services. Paresh, congratulations, firstly, on winning the award for the Best Rated 4 Hyperscale Data Center.
Thank you so much.
So, you know, Paresh, very quickly, I mean, it's a really exciting thing for us to have you with us right now. So, you know, if you could share some light, you know, you work with the financial institutions so closely. Given where we are today, if there is one thing that the financial institutions should be investing in, what would that be? I would like to hear your views on that.
There's a list of things, actually. To pinpoint one is quite a tough one. But if I have to prioritize one, or if there's one suggestion that I need to make, it is app modernization. Okay, so let me tell you the logic why. Did you ever voice out, you know, that you had a requirement for Facebook, Google, you know, Uber, or, you know, even Cred? It just came out. I mean, I don't think so. Jokingly also, we would have told any of our friends that we need any of these things, but it just came in. So basically, understanding the latent need and making it a necessity becomes a very important part. And that's where, you know, we got to make sure that we are able to give customers, they adopt it and they kind of start working on it. So in fact, 60% of the customers basically want to you know, be able to create that transaction or any financial transactions anywhere, anytime, from any devices. Okay, and they should have consistency across. I mean, that is what is coming out, and all this is very important to make sure that you know, they are able to get the same kind of service, whether they go offline or they go online. So that becomes a very important part. And now, if you have to, you know, give this kind of, you know, able to cater to the latent need of the customers, then you have to have technology that supports it. You can't have softwares which are, you know, old legacy systems which will be able to do this thing. So you got to change your legacy system. So that's why app modernization becomes important, which is a lean and mean way of, you know, a nimble system which is able to change according to the customer needs. They are able to innovate, they are able to bring in new products at any time, and within minutes they are able to, you know, kind of this. So app modernization becomes an important part, and with this we are able to, you know, modernize fast, you are able to monitor it, you are able to manage it, and that becomes a very important part. And so that you can cater to the customer needs which is there now, or also cater to their latent needs. So I would keep app modernization as the topmost thing.
In fact, very rightly said. In fact, app modernization is one of the most important things. You know, in fact, I completely agree with you. Moving on to my next question. In fact, I was part of the panel discussion where, you know, you spoke about the importance of AI and ML, right? So let's if you could just let us know once again, how important is AI and ML for the BFSI segment on the whole, from your perspective? Let's hear that.
I think from a technology perspective, you know, if there is one thing that they need to prioritize first from a, you know, from a technology perspective, it has to be AI. And most of the BFSI segment should have an AI first approach. Their entire strategy should be on there. There's so much of data available. They should be able to know how to capture it, how to collect it, how to analyze it, how to process it, and how to use it to acquire customers, to retain customers, to engage with them, and to manage with them. There are a lot of use cases of AI. I mean, I can go limitless, you know, but let me just tell you a few of the things. One is on the risk assessment. AI and ML helps you to do the risk assessment very well. I mean, they can look at behavioral, social behavior. They will be able to tell you which is, you know, there's going to be a fraud case, or there's a risk of non-payment. They understand social behaviors and all those things, and they'll be able to predict first that if there's going to be a default. Secondly, looking at, you know, credit card frauds and all the other scams, they will be able to preempt some of those things. So I think risk assessment becomes the important one. Then the second is credit worthiness. That's another use case, which is credit worthiness. You know, we use different tools. Now, current tools is basically on just whether you're paying your credit card bill or some of those things. But there are some social behaviors which you can look at and give you a score based on which you can be able to approve a financial transaction in minutes. And this accuracy is much more than the current physical systems that are available or whatever the system currently it's available. So creditworthiness will allow you to cater to new customer segments. It will be able to process it much faster. So the underserved segment is what you can cater. So you'll have a new segment which you can cater to. So that's a creditworthiness. That's the second one. Third is customer relationship management. I mean, by using AI, you should be able to manage relationships of customer understanding. I mean, if you are doing the social listening and you're able to analyze, you know, where you have to do it. So customer relationship management, more and more transactions will become human, and plus you'll have the non-human. So, and then you'll be able to give a human feel, and the chatbots can become more and more intelligent and personalize it, because customers will require the personalization. Not one customer's requirement of financials is same as the other one. So how do you differentiate yourself? You can't have a common thing made for everybody. So you got to personalize, and all this will happen via AI. There are a lot of other things, you know, sentiment analysis, you know, new product development, a lot of things which are AI enabled. But three main I would rate it as: risk assessment, credit worthiness, and customer relationship management. Also the, you know, smart wearables and smart speakers, these are also the other ones which we are coming into, because IoT is coming into picture. How do we use this to acquire, retain, build loyalty? That becomes the important part.
Right. In fact, I completely agree with you. So moving on, you know, to a very critical question now. We know that Control Edge is setting up several edge data centers, right? So if you could firstly share some light on that to all our viewers out here.
Well, I mean, we're very passionate and proud about, you know, what CtrlS has acquired. We as a team has acquired over the last, few years, 10 to 12 years. CtrlS is currently the Asia's largest Rated-4 data center. We started off in Hyderabad and then in Bombay. We are currently present in, four cities around with seven data centers. We plan to build up DC park in Mumbai and Hyderabad. We have more than 60 to 80 banking customers with us. You know, they have shown us the trust, and we basically, the success or the vision is basically shared with our customers who have been with us together. We plan to go into the other cities with regional data centers, but we are going to go to tier 2 and tier 3 cities to set up a huge amount of edge data centers. In the current one, you know, we are catering to almost more than 12,000 racks space only in Mumbai and Hyderabad to cater to our banking segment. But from an edge perspective, I think that's going to be the new thing. Once 5G gets rolled out, edge computing will become very, very important. And the BFSI segment, I think this will help improve the customer experience. The customer experience will improve considerably, with edge computing. I mean, supposing, you know, currently if you're having an ATM card and you're in a tier 2, tier 3 city, imagine that data goes back to verify in the main data centers or the data centers which is there. If I can set it at the edge, so this can become very fast. A lot of other services, whether it is insurance or some data which is based on IoT or AR or VR based, whatever IoT based data comes, we are able to do it. And imagine if it is the edge, if you put a 360 degree profile of a customer at the edge, you'll be able to improve his experience and also do a lot of more transactions with him. So I think edge computing is becoming important, and we are also riding on it, and we are going to invest much before the others. That's what our intention is. So we want to reach the tier 2, tier 3 so that we can give a good digital customer experience to our BFSI customers, enterprises.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Shetty. It was really nice listening to you. That's Mr. Shetty for you, the President Sales from Cloud4C Services, our exclusive winner for the Rated-4 Hyperscale Data Center in India. Thank you so much.